Hello and welcome to the ORM Mastery course. This tutorial is part of a bigger course which you can access via the YouTube Edition playlist link, which you'll find in the video description. If you really like this tutorial and want to learn more, then please check out our Django ORM Mastery course on Udemy. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Having now in the previous tutorial learned about signals, let's now put this into practice and build a simple application which is going to listen and receive a signal. You can use any of your existing applications, Django applications, to follow along. This code is available in the tutorial resources. You can download and follow along step by step. So here we have a basic setup. We have a core application, and then we have created an e-commerce app here. And inside of this, we have two simple models, product and category. To work with signals in Django, first of all, we need a signal. So there are already built-in signals, which we learned in the previous tutorial, that we can utilize, and we will be utilizing those in this tutorial. Or alternatively, you can create your own signal. So just moving back to the documentation signals that we saw in the previous tutorial, you can see here on the right-hand side, we have a number of different signals. We are focusing in here on the model signals, but you will find other default signals or built-in signals that you can utilize, which can be fairly useful in certain circumstances. So here we're going to focus in on the post save signal. So every time we save any data to any of our models here, we're going to just perform a simple action. In this case, it's just going to be a print to the terminal. So knowing that we're going to be utilizing the post save signal, next up, we're going to need to build a receiver function. So a receiver function is the function that's going to be initiated when the signal is sent. This receiver function will need to be registered or connected to the actual signal. So we need to make sure the signal exists if we're building a custom signal or not. And then we need to build the function and then register that function to the signal. So therefore, whenever the signal specified signal is initiated, then the receiver function is going to be run or initiated. Now, although here I've suggested that the receiver function that we build is connected to a single signal, in actual fact, we can build functions that are connected to multiple signals. So for simplicity in this example, we're going to be working within the apps.py file. If you're not familiar with the apps.py module, this is a module which is included by default when we create a new application, which allows us to create any customizations. We can configure the attributes of the application. So it will get initiated when we start a new Django application. And that's important because this file and the code will get initiated when we start our application. And thus what's going to happen here is that when we create our function, that's also then going to be initiated so that we can start to actually receive signals. So step one, we need to make sure that our signal exists. Of course, we're going to be utilizing the post save signal. So this is going to send a signal, send a notification anytime whenever a new instance is saved to any of our models. So let's go ahead and build our receiver function. So we're going to call this example receiver. And for now, let's just go ahead and just going to pass. Okay, so this is our receiver function. Well, in actual fact, we know what we're going to do here. We're going to print out to the terminal instance is saved, for example. The receiver function here will take in the sender argument along with a wildcard keyword argument. So we need to make sure that we include sender and then the keyword arguments. There we go. We will expand on this a little bit later, but by default, this is what we're told that we need to utilize, sender and keyword arguments. Okay, so at this point, we know that the signal already exists because we're using the built-in signal. And we have now built a receiver function. So what we need to do now is register or connect the receiver function to the signal so that when the signal occurs, the receiver function will be initiated. So first of all, let's go ahead and import our post save signal. Okay, so from Django DB. So we're specifically focusing here on signals related to the database. So Django DB model signals, import post save. So let's go ahead and add the ready function here. We didn't want all that, but that's okay. So our ready function here, so when our Django application starts, then it's going to import all these different apps that we have, and then it's going to initiate or read the apps module here. So after the app has been initiated, we want to run some code, and that's where we're going to connect our receiver function to our signal. The signal will have a connect method, and this is one of two ways that we can connect our receiver function here to our signal. So let's specify post save and then dot connect. And then we just need to specify what we want to run when the actual signal is sent. So in this case, it's our function called example.receiver or example underscore receiver. I have already migrated all the models here. So these two models are available. So if you haven't already, just migrate all the models. And now we can go ahead and go into the shell. And let's go ahead and import, from e-commerce, let's import, for example, product. Okay, so I've done that wrong. E-commerce.models, import product. There we go. Right, so now we have our product in place. Let's go ahead and try and add some data to our product table. So let's go product. And then we know that there's only one field, name equals test. Okay, and then we go ahead and save this. Now, as soon as we run this save function, that's going to send the signal to anything that's registered to the save signal. Now, at the moment, we've registered our new receiver function here to that particular signal that will be sent out whenever we save a new instance to our model. So what should happen here is that when we save the data, the post save signal will be sent out, and then this function will get initiated. So let's give that a go. It should say print instance to is saved. So let's give that a go. Press enter, and you can see that's happened. So the signal has been received, this function has been initiated, and we print out to the terminal. Of course, this is a very simple unrelated example just to showcase and to get a feel of signals in Django. Throughout this section of the course, or throughout these sections at level two of this course, we will keep dipping into signals. And this is why we're introducing it now, of course, so that we have a basic underpinning knowledge so that later on we can just get to actually building different signals. So if you're worried about different examples and real use cases, we will follow that up later on in this course. But hopefully you can start to see the dynamics now that's required in order to actually capture or receive a signal. So at this point, you had the basics now to explore some of these other signals. Now, what's happening at the moment, of course, is that any instance that we save in any model is going to be captured, and then our receiver function is going to be initiated. But of course, we can specify the model as well, and we'll take a look at that in the next tutorial.